Hello there guys, Coast Shell here, Dongstonborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a theme park newsroom update. This is a big news update today from Pleasure Wood Hills. Now, of course, before we get started, you'll have seen that we've re-uploaded the interview with the SNS European Director of Sales, Lars Lenders. I managed to get the visuals working, and we've finally been able to upload the full version of that. So that is already up on the channel for you guys to watch for yourselves. And also, we've got plenty more videos coming, including the early prediction videos. They are back in the next week or two. In fact, no, scratch that, the next week. So give it a few days and the first one will be on there. And basically, of course, Six Flags, Cedar Fair, Merlin Entertainment's theme parks, early 2022 predictions. So stay tuned for those videos as well. But before we get started, guys, like, comment, subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss another YouTube video. Make sure you go in the description down below where not only can you find links to Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, Snapchat, and also the Discord server where you, yes, you, the Coast Shell fanbase, can be a part of the Channel Nation and interact with other Coast Shell fans. You can also find the link to the Google Forms where you can submit your video ideas and be involved in sharing ideas and suggestions for content in the future. And for now, guys, let's get straight into this video. So the video today from Pleasurewood Hills is all about the Fireball at Pleasurewood Hills, of course. So Fireball is a KMG afterburner, and it is officially up for sale. Now we're going to be discussing the stats, facts, and history on this ride, and also share a couple of replacements that we could see in place of the Fireball in the near future. So please like, comment, subscribe, guys, and let's get into talking about the stats, facts, and history of Fireball at Pleasurewood Hills in Lowest. So it first opened back in 2004 with a capacity of 24 per cycle. This KMG afterburner was previously called Whizzy Dizzy, and by 2011 it received the current name of Fireball. Now, as mentioned on the park's website, get hot under the collar and take on this roaring Fireball. The floor will disappear from beneath your dangling feet, and you'll stare into the eyes of all 23 of its other riders as you swing like a pendulum, hypnotizing onlookers. You'll be flung 20 meters in the air through 120 degrees, but all numbers and scents will fly out of your mind as you watch the ground sail past you at different angles in a matter of seconds. Not for the faint-hearted, and you know what they say, if you can't stand the heat, well, you finished that sentence. But yeah, Fireball, very interesting from the park's website, and of course, very wonderful stats. Now, there is two main ride predictions for replacements of the Fireball, and I'm going to share them right now. So, beautiful stats, facts, and history there, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages, on the Fireball. And, like I said, two replacements that have been mentioned a lot on forums, on fan pages, especially Pleasurewood Maniac. Shout out to them because they put two very interesting suggestions for replacements. Now, the first replacement is, or the first replacement option is, Eagle's Claw at Lightwater Valley being relocated to Pleasurewood Hills as a permanent looking replacement to the Fireball. Now, whether that means Eagle's Claw gets a retheme and a rename and a relook and a repaint to it, but it is a more permanent looking KMG afterburner. And, you know, I think that wouldn't be a bad option to go for. I think that overall, I think that the Eagle's Claw is obviously a very good ride for Lightwater Valley. I think it's been great to them, but of course, they announced just recently in the last few weeks that they are going to permanently remove the ride along with Black Pearl. We'll get onto that in a minute. Raptor Attack and a couple of other rides, the Rapids as well. So Lightwater Valley announcing all these closures, and Raptor Attack is one of them, and Eagle's Claw is another one. Eagle's Claw, in my opinion, I think would work very, very well at Pleasurewood Hills as a permanent Fireball replacement. A rethemed, repainted, relooked KMG afterburner, permanent KMG afterburner, and I think that would bring a sense of more permanent attraction types to Pleasurewood Hills and give them the proper looking direction they're going to go in. Now, the second replacement, possible replacement for this ride is Black Pearl from Lightwater Valley. Again, another Lightwater Valley relocation, but the reason why I've gone for a Black Pearl is because of a previous ride that Pleasurewood Hills had called The Tempest. Now, The Tempest, again, was a looping ship, and overall, The Tempest was a historic ride for Pleasurewood Hills, and it carries a bit of a weight of history with it. I mean, you know, some diehard fans of Pleasurewood Hills will they'll know the history of the Tempest ride. Obviously, you know, it's had its interesting stats, and it's had its interesting thing. And of course, this isn't the same ride system as the Tempest. However, you know, I think bringing in the Black Pearl could be a nice way to use the updated ride system to bring back their history to the park. Now, of course, the Tempest was brought in 1990, and it sat alongside the newly refurbished Rattlesnake roller coaster, which operated previously as the Ladybird, and it was removed back at the end of 1994, replaced by the Dodgems. Now, of course, that information was from Pleasurewood Place, an unofficial fan site. Now, the Tempest, of course, like I say, is a legendary ride, and I think that maybe they could do with bringing that ride back. Now, like I said, it isn't the actual, original Tempest ride system. However, bringing in Black Pearl would be a nice way to sort of tie into that history, and it's sort of, you know, repackage it as like the Tempest Reborn, which would be really, really nice. Now, a third suggestion that I've personally got, which was not mentioned on other sites, is maybe they could go with an Intamin Gyro Swing or a Zamperla Discovery Revolution. Now, this is probably the most least likely of suggestions. However, I don't think that's completely out of the question, though. I think that, you know, with the removal of a KMG Afterburner, it's a type of frisbee slash claw swinging ride. So I would like to see them maybe go down the line of bringing in another one of these type of claw slash frisbee swinging rides. And the Zamperla Discovery Revolution would be great. It's very much a Six Flags edition, but I like what they're doing with those. So you wouldn't expect the Giant Discoveries or the Giga Discoveries. You'd be expecting the Discovery Revolution, the more smaller version. Something more on the lines of Cyclonator, which is opening as part of Tornado Springs at Poulton's Park. Something like that. Or they go with the Intamin Gyro Swing route, and there's plenty of options around them of Europe. You know, you've got Tigeren at the Jersey Summerland. You've got Loki at Leesburg. So you've got examples of these in Europe. Maelstrom at Drayton Manor is a big example here in the UK for Intamin Gyro Swings. And, you know, they're keeping that ride at the minute, especially in the new direction of the Looping Group. It looks like Maelstrom's here to stay anyway. So I think that Intamin Gyro Swing would work very, very well at Pleasurewood Hills, especially if, you know, Pleasurewood Hills are owned by the Looping Group, and they've got the Intamin Gyro Swing, which is Maelstrom at Drayton Manor. I'd like to see a version of Maelstrom at Pleasurewood Hills as well. And of course, they're in different parts of the UK. Drayton Manor's in Tamworth, Pleasurewood Hills is in Lowestoft. So very, very different from each other. And it would give that region of the UK that kind of ride experience, that gyro swing ride experience. And again, they could even pay homage to one of their former rides. They could give it the Fireball name, or they could do a gyro swing and bring in the Tempest name, if they're not going to bring back the original ride system of the Tempest. So I'd like to see them work with gyro swing and work with the theming companies as well, because if you look at gyro swings, they like to, I mean, you look at Tigeren, for example, at the Jersey Summerland, the theming around that. And, you know, there's loads of theming companies you can work with. Universal Rocks, Jorovision Europe, wonderful theming companies. And they could do some really nice scenery and landscaping item and theming items as well around the ride. So I'd like something like Tigeren or Loki or Maelstrom with that kind of theming level. And again, use the name The Tempest, because I think that brings back a lot of history. It ties into the history of the park. And it brings in a brand new kind of gyro swing ride experience to that region of the UK. So that'll be one suggestion I would go down. It's probably the least likely, because it's very, very costly to bring in a gyro swing from scratch compared to buying a Lightwater Valley attraction that's closing, like Eagle's Claw or the Black Pearl. So, you know, it's the least likely in terms of costs and financial situation, but it would be the more likely in terms of a new ride experience that would prove that Pleasurewood Hills is going in the right direction experience-wise, not just theme park-wise. So I wouldn't be surprised if we go down the Lightwater Valley buyout options, but I would like the Gyro Swing option or Discover Revolution by Zamperla option as well. And you look at the thing, what they did with Cyclonator at Poulton's Park, what they're doing for that as part of Tornado Springs for this year. The theming level on that is great as well. So I'd like either one. Either option would be great. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this theme park news update, looking at the up for sale Fireball of Pleasurewood Hills. My name is Coast Chow. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. And for now, guys, see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Keep living the coast of life. Have a thrill-tastic day. Go on, Pleasurewood Hills.